Hey, mister! Remember me? Come on over! Look at this, my friend. Tobacco. Nature's gift to us all. Focuses the mind like nothing else.
Whatever you say.
Well, I say, why buy it off the shelves when you can make your own? Well, plenty left here if you're interested. I'd best keep moving.
Let's go, girl.
Yeah.
By order of Judge Meredith Holden in the courts of the state of Lemoyne, we do hereby grant repossession of this property and all items herein to the Bank of Rhodes. M. Holden, Judge Holden, Henrietta Blackley, clerk, November 18th, 1895.
Ledger, watch, pistol.
June 7th, 1855. Dear sir, please accept this likeness of your family as a small token of appreciation for your assistance in the recovery of my property. Like your old paw, you're a cunning old dog and a credit to this community. Yours, Colonel Joshua Nixon, the Ascension Plantation. Dear Jeremiah, there ain't nothing here of any value. I wouldn't give you a nickel for it. Come by for a sup of whiskey anytime. Bill. Yes. I was sorry to hear of Betsy's passing. Things is easier up there for sure. Thank you.
That's the old watch. Now the ledger and the pistol.
April 2nd, 1870. Dear Mr. Thompson, I'm afraid there's no more work for you down here at the plantation. I'm grateful for the help you've given us, and the help your pappy and your pappy's pappy gave us before you. These are trying times for all of us. You are in our thoughts and prayers. Yours truly, Colonel J. Nixon, the Ascension Plantation.
Okay, where is all this old crap?
Paw, God damn it. Told you to stay away from the boy. He don't want this. Heck, none of us want nothing to do with you. Rance.
Trap door, huh?
What you doing here? We found this place first.
Yeah.
Easy. I'm just looking around for some things. That old revolver yours?
Finders keepers.
God! Son of a bitch!
Oh, goddammit!
Come on, man!
Where are you going? Come on! It's ours!
Bless you!
You're dead.
Dear Mr. Thompson, after numerous complaints from customers and fellow employees alike, we must terminate your employment. There's just no place for a man like you at the Central Union Railroad Company.
Just the ledger now.
Well, that's that. I was somewhere near Rhodes when they caught me. Till the day I die, I ain't gonna forget the sound of that dog barking in my heels. But I don't suppose that day gonna be far off yet. It was 50 lashings yesterday and 50 more to come. I don't think I can take any more. Man said he was doing his job. Funny kind of employment if you ask me, but I suppose you ain't. Light's fading, so that's it for now. I do hope I live to see the end of this war and justice win out. Ugh. June 64.
God. This your ledger? A list of slaves?
Rewards. January 15th, Betsy, $17. January 18th, Louise, $12. May 18th, Wilfred, $18. May 24th, Minnie and Child, $20.
They threw us away like shit on their boot.
Times wasn't perfect, I ain't...
Oh, man!
Oh, man! You show some respect. I was respected once. I had a profession.
You asked me to get you something.
There's no bringing back what I want. I want my job, my pride, the respect accorded to a gentleman.
What about this old crap? Huh?
My things. Don't you understand? Those bastards, they changed everything. I was a good worker. I took pride in my work. They took it away. Pissed on my legacy.
Old man, some jobs ain't for saving. And some legacies?
Oh,
they are for pissing.
What are you doing? That's my history. Damn you! Damn you! I still exist! Oh.
Yep.
We've been waiting for you, Arthur.
Well, I'm sorry to have kept you.
Come on, let's get going.
What's the plan?
We're meeting a couple of the Greys over at the saloon. They spoke to Bill about a job needing security.
After the farce of stealing the horses for them, why are we doing this?
Because we need to stay in with them, and they're paying.
So what kind of security they want?
We're about to find out. Now come on.
This seemed legit to you, Bill?
Sure. Dutch said we was to keep on dealing with them until we find this gold.
Can we trust them?
Can we trust anyone?
Yeah. Let's just see what they say.
They said there was some big misunderstanding about them horses.
And what about boarding in their fields?
They don't know we had anything to do with that.
Oh, that's so.
Yeah. They think it was the Braithwaites. Listen, I know these Grey boys a bit now. This is on the level.
We're stuck in the middle of some ancient feud, but instead of playing both sides, we're being used by both of them.
They were saying the Catherine Braithwaite.
Hey, hold up. This don't feel right.
Now it don't feel right? I could have told you.
Round it up.
We'd have had to deal with these sons of bitches sooner or later. Just turned out to be sooner. See that? Those cowards running away.
Looks like most of them.
Not all of them.
Sheriff Gray. And what about Bill? Where the hell's he?
We'll find him later. Come on. Sheriff Gray! You need to get a hold on this town. It's going to hell.
What do you think you are? Bunches, two big thugs from God knows where? You're so dumb to think we don't know what you've been doing.
Come out, Sheriff. It's over.
We put down far worse than you. 100 times over. This is the Gray's town. Always has been. Always will be.
Only Grays I see left around here is you.
You want us to come out? We'll come out.
Shit.
Oh, Bill.
Guns on the ground now. Both of you, don't do it.
You know we can't do that. You put the gun down, Sheriff.
I'll blow his brains out.
You want to join your little friend there, do you?
How the hell was I to know?
Let me see. They set us up once before. They didn't like us. We destroyed their farm. Should I go on?
Go easy on him, Morgan.
He was out trying to find a lead. Same as you. Same as Hosea. All you do is complain when things don't work out. Except when it's your goddamn fault.
You don't know what you're talking about. You don't give a damn about nobody but yourself.
Oh, you act so high and mighty, but you're no better than the rest of us. I've ridden with you boys close on, what, 6 months now? And all you ever done was complain. You can fight, but you can't think.
You can't do either.
Okay, cowpoke.
Bill, take the boy's body. Bury him proper someplace, quiet. Micah, best you and I don't speak for a moment.
I'm just so frightened by you.
Get out of my sight, pair of fools.
Sean has been killed. His head shot half off in an ambush. Still no Confederate gold, but a shitload of trouble. Down.
looking for him. Everybody's out there right now.
Arthur, have you seen that boy, Jack?
No.
Where's my goddamn son? Where is he? Where's my son? They took him, didn't they? They took my son.
Who took him?
We think the Braithwaite woman took him.
Oh.
But Kieran saw a couple of fellows sound like Braithwaite boys.
Where's my son? If anything, where is my son, Dutch Vanderlyn?
We will find him, we will bring him back to you, and we will kill any fool that had the temerity to touch one hair on that boy's head. Abigail, you have my word.
Just get me back, my son.
I will get that boy back, so help me God. Right now.
Dutch, we just heard about Jack. You need some extra guns?
Yeah, why not? Micah, Kieran, anyone strange turns up, you kill them. Rest of you, let's ride. Okay, let's go get that boy back.
They must have figured out what we was up to, Dutch.
Yeah, we just...
Shot to hell by the Grays in town.
I know. I heard about Sean, too. I don't want to even think about that right now. We have to focus on Jack.
I swear, I'll kill everyone there.
Easy, John. Try to stay calm.
I'm fine.
How the hell did they get to him?
I don't know. But we are getting him back, and they will pay. I promise you that.
What about the gold?
Who gives a damn about the gold? They got Jack.
I hate to break it to you, but I don't think there is any gold. Or if there is, it's hidden somewhere no one knows.
What?
I've turned every stone.
Christ's sake, Hosea. After all that, another perfect scam.
We underestimated them.
No, they underestimated us. Enough talk. There is no point arguing how we got here. This is where we are. And we are going to fix it. So come on! Okay, get your heads right. Nobody makes a move until I say so.
Now, Jack, we should have stayed out of all of this.
Bit late for that, ain't it?
Quiet. We're going to fix this right now. Come on, let's get this done.
John, you sure you're okay?
Like I said, I'm fine.
Follow my lead. Both these redneck families think they can ruin us? I don't think so.
There they are.
Who steals a goddamn boy?
I'm gonna let fly at those sons of bitches!
John, I need you to stay calm. Get down here now! You inbred trash!
Easy, John.
We've come for the boy. You must have known we would.
Shouldn't have messed with our business now, should you?
Whatever complaint you have with us, alleged or otherwise, that is a young boy. That is not the way you do things. Hand him over.
Get the hell off our land.
If you ain't gonna be civilized about this...
Thank you.
can't see a goddamn thing! One, two, three! No!
Where's the boy?
We have lived in this house for 120 years. We never had no problems except for
Yankees. Where is the boy? Who took him?
You killed my sons!
Oh, and I will surely kill the rest of them unless you start talking.
Oh, I know your time. Common scum.
Where is the boy?
You filth.
All right. We get her out of here.
What about down?
Now let's get this hag outside. Any more of her sons to deal with?
No, reckon they're all dead.
That's right. Burn this dog to the ground.
You boys sure Jack ain't in here?
We searched everywhere, Dutch.
Guess that's the end of the goddamn cribbage game.
Come here!
Put me down, you damn Yankee! I never liked you.
Why'd you take the boy, Mrs. Braithwaite?
You stole my
boys are off limits.
You stole my horses. Ain't no rules in war, Mr.
Matthews.
Yes, yes, that's it.
Where's the boy?
My sons gave him to Angelo Bronte. So my guess is Saint-Denis. Either there or on the boat to Italy.
Let's go.
Arthur, come on.
What are we doing with her?
Leave her.
I told you she was crazy.
It's gonna work out, John. It's gonna work out. Listen to Dutch.
Now, I don't expect you to understand this, but I have never been more proud of you than I am right now, brother. You're doing the right thing.
If I don't get that boy back safe, she'll kill us all.
I know, but looking at this logically, well, that boy is fine. They took him to scare us. Nobody takes a boy to harm him.
He's right, John.
What do you think, Arthur?
My boy will be fine. But, well, of course, Marston's scared rotten. I mean, we killed all those people. We stirred up all that trouble for nothing.
No, no, not for nothing. For living. Now, we get that boy back, and we go. Trust me.
Hey, Dutch, we got a problem.
Not a problem. Visitors. A solution. Good day, fine people. Mr. Vanderlind, Mr. Matthews, I presume. And who are you?
Rip Van Winkle.
Huh. Good day, sir. Agent Milton, Pinkerton Detective Agency. Agent Ross. Ah, Mr. Morgan, nice to see you again.
And to what do we owe the pleasure, Agent Moron?
I don't know if you're aware, but this is a civilized land now. We didn't kill all them savages only to allow the likes of you to act like human dignity and basic decency was outmoded or not yet invented. This thing, It's done.
This place ain't no such thing as civilized.
It's man, so in love with greed, he has forgotten himself and found only appetites.
And as a consequence, that lets you take what you please, kill whom you please, and hang the rest of us? Who made you the messiah to these lost souls you've led so horribly astray?
I'm nothing but a seeker, Mr. Milton.
You ain't much of anything more than a killer, Mr. Vanderlinde. But I came to make a deal. It's time. You come with me, and I give the rest of you 3 days to run off, disappear, and go and live like human beings someplace else.
You came for me? Risk life and limb in this den of lowlifes and murderers so that they might live and love? Ain't that fine?
I don't want to kill all these folk, Dutch. Just you.
In that case, it'd be my honor to join you. Excuse me, friends. I have an appointment to keep with.
I think your new friend should leave now, Dutch.
You're making a big mistake. All of you.
Yeah, dreadful. We have got something. Something to live and die for. How awful for us.
Mr. Milton, stop following us. We'll be gone soon.
I'm afraid I can't. And when I return, I'll be with 50 men. All of you will die. Run away from this place, you fools! Run!
Come on.
Get your damn hands off of me, boy.
What now? We get out of here. And quick. Any ideas?
I know a big old house, hidden in the swamps outside Saint Denis. I'm sure they'll find us eventually, but it should buy us a few days.
A few days is all we need.
There's a spot out by Shady Bell. Lenny and I got into that dispute with the previous occupiers. Place is well hidden.
You and Arthur, ride out to make sure no one else has moved in. Lenny, you go follow those fools out of here. Make sure that they leave.
And John, we'll get Jack back, and we'll get going.
Rest of you, get packing!
Come on, John.
This is crazy.
We'll get packed up, but we need a new spot, Arthur.
Follow me. I know the way. It's gonna be all right, John.
We should be going for Jack.
We will. We have to move everyone first before that bastard Milton comes back with an army. We ain't no use to Jack in jail or at the end of a rope.
I don't even know what to think no more.
Just gotta keep our cool. Be smart about this.
Smart? Are you joking? We made too much noise once again. We drew it right to us. I mean, how many people we killed the past few weeks?
Far too many.
It's Dutch playing his games.
Yeah, I guess I'll
Hosea,
say that.
Too. Getting involved with those two families. Master con men working their magic.
They thought there was a lot of gold.
Yeah, they thought there was money. Ain't there always?
Look, Marston, I don't know what to tell you. Things don't always work out. That ain't nothing new.
Jack's gone. We lost Sean, Mac, Davey, Jenny. And for what?
We can't change what's done. We can only move on.
But one day, we need to start learning from our mistakes.
Come on, it ain't all bad. We've had a rocky run. We'll be okay. We'll get through.
Dutch will fix it. Dutch will come up with a big plan. Right now, every plan gets us into worse trouble. We're getting further from where we're meant to be going.
Now, you can't put all this on. Dutch, you're worked up. Rightly so. Don't get too far in your head with all this. You'll never get out. All right? Should be just down this path to the left here.
It's a goddamn mess. That poor kid. We chose this life. He didn't.
I don't know. I think this life chose us.
You, me, Dutch, Hosea. It's been a long time now.
That's it up ahead.
Four walls and a roof. We're moving up in the world.
You ain't seen inside it yet.
Come on. The sooner we get this done, the better. You sure this place is empty?
I ain't sure on nothing.
All right. Let's leave the horses here and take a look.
Oh, shit! It's them again!
Damn it! Still some here.
I can see that. You think there's more of them?
I'll check the house. You keep watch out here. Any more of you upstairs? I'm coming for you. You hear me?
Come on. I got a bullet here waiting for you.
Come out with your hands up. You can still walk out of here.
I knew you'd come soon enough. You are some of the coward, like you. The bounty hunters, the freedmen, the carpetbaggers, the army of criminals who stole our land and our government. I survived them all. Our fight will live on.
Jesus. Last one.
Good. Come help me with this, will you? You coming? Here. Give me a hand moving these bodies. Don't want the others walking into this. Follow me. This way. We'll dump the bodies in the swamp over there.
Okay. I can deal with the rest of the bodies. You go meet up with the caravan. Guy in the mill. Thank you. my humble abode. We got fine living. You know the corpses and the alligators, it's paradise.
I love it. Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, would you two kindly work your magic? Arthur, take a ride with me.
Sure.
Come on.
George?
Yes?
Could I have a word with you?
Not now. Come on, Arthur. Can you believe that, girl? All I've got going on, and she wants to talk.
Everything okay with you two?
I got far more important things to worry about right now than Molly O'Shea.
So, where are we going?
To take a look at this eighth wonder of the civilized world, Saint Denis, I keep hearing about. According to the map, the road up this way should lead us right in there.
All right. I guess this day ain't over yet.
Not quite. Good work back there, Arthur. Everything went okay?
Few loose ends. Nothing major.
And John?
About what you'd expect. He's taking it hard.
We are going to get that boy back, whatever it takes. I need you to start asking around in the city for Bronte. Subtly, of course. Public places, maybe start with the saloons. Anyone who can put us in contact with him.
Of course. What about the Pinkertons?
I'm fairly sure nobody followed us. We moved out fast. We should be safe for a few days here.
And then?
I think we need to move a little further. Put some ocean between us and all of this. The mess with those two families. Losing Sean. I see things differently now. For a long time, I truly believed the paradise lay somewhere in the west for us. But I just don't know anymore.
So we're leaving the country now?
Maybe. I'm still thinking about it. Whatever we do, we'll need more money. In any case, we have more pressing matters to attend to first. Okay, there she is. A real city. The future.
Big cities, they're
always repellent.
Exactly.
I'll find you in there. Go see what you can figure out.
Yes.
Mister, have you seen Gavin?
You still haven't found him?
Nope, but I won't give up. He's lost. One morning, I just woke up and he wasn't there. Someone must have taken him.
Maybe he just left.
Gavin? No. No. We were best mates. I mean, really, best mates. He'd never leave me. Never.
I can't believe what I just said.
I am so worried.
Gav! 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 Where are you?
Where are you?
Oh, well.
Hey, officer. out of the damn way!
Stick 'em up, cowboy.
Yeah, real funny, Dutch.
Oh, I thought so. So, here we are in a strange land of papists and rapists. America's very own Gomorrah.
This city's all of the same to me. So, how you get on?
I've been asking around about Mr. Bronte. From what I've heard, this establishment is our best lead, but I haven't had any joy in there so far.
So, I should just give it a shot?
I think so. Just keep it cool.
You know me?
I'll meet you back here anon.
Funny you should say that.
Well, you know how it is. I told him. I say, that's the state of Lemoyne for you.
Over
America's
here.
Dirty little French secret.
That's why we love it.
Born and raised.
Well,
I'll get you in a second.
Not unless we all get washed away.
Every year they say that's gonna happen. It ain't happened yet. Let me tell you something. The rest of the states, they lucky to have us. If it wasn't for us, they'd probably have run back to Britain with the tails between their legs at the first sign of trouble.
You got that right.
Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Sure. That's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Well, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, friend.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, friend. You and your pal that was in here before.
Bronte? Angelo Bronte? Mr. Big? Mr. Italian spaghetti eating long streak of piss big. Yeah, he makes my skin crawl. I'm so swally, a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you talk to them kids in the alley, they'll know, I guess. Oh, and friend, you'll be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Now, this sulking doesn't become you.
You always have to...
Pardon me, but have you seen any kids around this way?
Yeah, I think I heard a few in the other courtyard up ahead. You can get through on the left there. You got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte, Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost?
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where's he live, New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. If you don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
breath. Here. Come on.
This away. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but,
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, hey, you little pair of shits!
Get going! He's coming after us!
I'll kill you, you thieving bastard!
Shit went that way.
Thanks for the help, friend.
You know, I kind of miss old bobtails.
I don't bounce around so much. Couldn't even read the newspaper.
Remember when they had to bring the mules back out after the snowstorm in 95? Couldn't get the ice off the trolley.
That was absolutely delicious, my dear. Thank you. Well, I think the toast is in order, don't you? Here, let's fill that water glass, Target. It's unlucky to cheers on an empty glass. Okay. To the trombone.
Come on! Keep up!
You better stop right now!
Hey! Moron!
Bye, mister!
My mistake.
I'm telling you, a cucumber's definitely a fruit.
Fellas, you seen a kid come through here? About 14, 15?
Oh, yeah, he ran right through us. Ran around the corner there.
How can you damn?
What do you have?
What's the problem, friend?
Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is,
and he robbed from me. Now give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
The kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just want to speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friend should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Sir.
Hey, mister.
Come on.
Howdy.
I know you got some money.
Hey.
Hi there.
Touched.
Help me, Jesus!
Welcome. Earl Bodine's cure comes guaranteed. Well, I take it myself sometimes.
Okay, let's see what I want.
Who by?
Bunch of children. Oh.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John. You meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less. the swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east to land we know, and far from real open country. Hey, girl.
Good morning.
Bonjour. Hey, now.
There you are.
You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much. Just these some slick little greasy-haired Europeans. Clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up the place, boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John?
I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen.
Run along now, boy.
Psst.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax. You looking for a problem? I got this.
Don't worry, boys. We come in peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have.
Now, we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business!
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words, you lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Ti adoro. Date da bere sti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course, they're on the mild. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, why you tell me more about my manners? Salute.
Salute.
Grave robbers? You think he's taking us for a fool?
No idea. What choice do we have?
None, I guess. This is idiotic.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were gonna hold Jack ransom. for all the money we cost him. We must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaite's left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right. Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead. This way. Come on. Let's find him and get the hell out of here. Keep it down. Don't want him to bolt on us.
Looks like someone beat us to it here. Once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word. Where are these sons of bitches? Goddamn place. I mean, gosh darn shithole.
Keep on them.
This is starting to make my skin crawl. Stay quiet. We don't want to spook them. I thought today was gonna turn out. This sure weren't one of them.
I hear something in there.
You boys found my pappy's watching!
Here someplace.
Okay, but we'll need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
Come on. Let's quickly check that spot where it all kicked off.
Think there might be something in here. Got it.
Good. Now let's get out of here. Damn, law's here. Come on, let's see if that gate's open. Locked. Let's just track back to where we came in.
Damn it. Come
best stick to the side. Them for now. Come on. Let's just get there.
Well,
let's get back to
this. It's lucky I ain't a religious man.
Let's just get back there. Collect our side of the deal.
You all right?
He best not be playing games with us.
He almost certainly is. Let's just see. Keep your head. Act normal.
How's he even gonna know we did what he asked?
Feeling most things around here get back to him pretty fast.
You took your time.
Jack! Where's your host?
Ha! Like I said, you took your time.
I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend. Thank Mr. Bronte for everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
You know, Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys. Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it. All right, let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What? What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teach me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs. One for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time. But I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like you wouldn't know.
You had a nice night then?
Most enjoyable. Well, the man's an intolerable blowhard, but he stocks a fine bar. How did you fellers get on? Any problems?
A whole heap of them. We about doubled the population of that graveyard.
You know, I thought I heard gunshots, but the gramophone was playing.
Unbelievable.
Each to their strengths, Arthur. I went in there with a gun and left with a party invitation.
So, what'd you say this was? A garden party?
A big gala at the mayor's house. I'm told every rich fool in Lemoyne will be there.
Bronte?
Oh! He'll be there, too. Seems to more or less run this city. At least, that's the way he sees it. Could open up some opportunities for us. It's been a chaotic few days. But we can finally move forward now.
Hey, they're back! I think I see Jack!
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian food. Did you ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch Arthur, thank you. Thank you. I got my son back.
Jack. How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So...
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys, we got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Hey, thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Hey, make some room for John there.
Come on, are we still waiting for your boy? Yeah,
let's go. Come on,
give it.
Cheers.
How about a song?
Huh? How are you?
Out of the air. Play us away.
Bella Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. Bella Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando.
Ay, 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 ay. Canta, no llores,
porque cantando se alegra el cielito lindo los corazones. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca.
Ay, 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 ay,
canta, no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones. No se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones.
All right, let's give this boy a bit of space.
See you later.
Good to have you back, Jackie.
We missed you.
Welcome back, Jack.
Thanks.
You must be starving, son. Let me get you something to eat.
Thanks, Mama. Can I play a little?
Como el coyotito, que los revuelco y los dejo.
You're good.
I'm very relieved. We all are.
Yeah. Thank God it worked out.
Welcome back, Jack.
Thanks, Uncle Jose.
Well, I'll let you fine folks get reacquainted.
Hello.
Here you are. Eat up.
Thanks.
Tahiti, dear boy. Tahiti. If you say so. Mangoes, maidens, paradise. An unspoiled paradise.
Yeah, I hope so.
Faith, Arthur. Have a little faith.
I'm sorry, Paris.
Anyway, I got caught by some new country sheriff.
Now you, live a little.
I might have a couple.
This is a party. Come on.
All right, all right.
Boring bastard. Oh,
some folks thought it was unfair. And at the hanging there was a riot. They went to lynch me. But someone I never saw, he shot the rope. Clean through. Instead, they hanged the sheriff. And I got away with nothing more than a sore neck. Was you scared? Absolutely petrified.
Fair enough.
Hello, Karen.
Come on. Let's leave the play a bit.
Welcome home, little Jack.
All right.
Reckon I'm gonna turn in.
Yeah.
humbled me.
You okay, Pearson?
Screwed me to the wall.
Yes, indeed.
He never let me
feels like we can move forward.
No sleep at all. He up me and he down me and he caught me out. And he fucked me black and blue.
Tide comes in, tide goes out.
I was thinking, maybe it would be a little easier for me to keep an eye on him if we all stayed together. You know, in my room.
You mean like a normal family?
Look around you. Ain't nothing normal about any of this.
Right about that.
Look after that kid.
Oh, I will.
He's a brave boy.
And we made it. We are gonna make it.
Hi, Pearson.
We have a plan. My friends. My loved ones. A plan. It is a real plan. We are gonna leave this place, and we are gonna find our own paradise. Australia, the real new world, not this
go to bed. Please. Herein. Go to bed.
Guns, my sermons, the stones, a parson's a wolf on his pulpit.
Pretty fired up there.
We are going to do this, Arthur. It ain't just talk.
I believe you. Thank you.